owner.
Give us your name and, yeah, name and title for audio level, and then away we go.
Good afternoon. My name is Fisaha Unduche. I'm the chief flood forecaster for the province of Manitoba. As most of you are aware of, most parts of Manitoba, with the exception of northern and northern western part of Manitoba, has received a significant amount of precipitation in the past few days. Specifically, as of this morning, in the past 7 days, we have seen a precipitation record between 50 to 100 millimeters in some areas. Most of this precipitation occurred as snow in the western, central, interlake areas, and snow rain mix in the southern and southeastern portion of the province. Rivers, lakes, and streams in south and southeast Manitoba, including the areas of the Roseau River, Rat River, in that area, are either at near peak or has already been peaked, but we still continue monitoring that area. There is some localized overland flooding in southeast portion of Manitoba, and that localized overland flooding will continue for a few more days because it will take a few more days for the rivers to recess. There is still significant amount of precipitation in central southern portion of Manitoba, in areas along the Pembina River, Boyne River. In that area, we still have significant amount of precipitation, snow on the ground. Temperature is forecast to fluctuate between 0 to 4 degrees centigrade in the coming couple of days, and temperatures forecast to pick up to daily time high of plus 10 starting end of this week, starting Thursday and Friday. So with that, we expect flow will start to, runoff will start to kick up, and with that we expect to see more runoff into rivers and lakes in central, southern, and interlake regions. Levels on the Red River continue to rise, on average about a foot a day in the past few days, and we expect the peak flow and the level will come within the Red River Valley somewhere between October 20 to 23. The Red River floodway expected to operate until the end of October, after it was being activated on 7 p.m. on October 9. This is done based on Rule 4 operation in order to limit the level in the city of Winnipeg. The current Red River level at James Avenue within the city of Winnipeg is 15 feet. It is expected to crest between 16 and 16.3 feet with the operation of the floodway. There is some moderate precipitation in the forecast in the coming 5 to 7 days, and we expect we'll continue to monitor that system, and we don't know how much of that system is still certain, but we are closely monitoring the system. As the runoff starts to kick off in the southern and the central parts of Manitoba, we are working closely with the municipalities, with the local governments, and monitoring the overland flooding condition in the area, and we'll brief if there's any overland flooding develops. Provincial staff are also monitoring impacted areas in the southern and the southeastern portion of the province, including the White Shell Lakes area, which are near crest at this moment in time. So things looking stable in southern, southeastern portion of the province. We still continue monitoring interlake, southwestern and central part of the province, as there is still about 50 to 70 millimeters of snow water cubanes that's going to contribute in the coming couple of days. So this is what it looks like, the basin condition, and we are continue monitoring the precipitation system as it forecasted and as it try to come. Between October 20 to 23.
20 to 23. Yes. Grand Forks is expecting a National Weather Service is expecting a Pembina crest on October 22nd.
Yes.
So it's a simultaneous sort of.
So we look at two scenarios. One is when our local peak coincides with the American peak, and the other is when it doesn't coincide. So if our local peak coincides with the American, then that's when we are looking for October 23. Our early peak on October 20 may come based on some of the runoff from the American and some of from the local flow contribution. So the coming couple of days, the rise in temperature, really matters, because the western part of the Red River tributaries haven't picked up yet, so they start to pick up yet. So that's part of the contributing factor to the peak.
So just make it easy for me, so
20 to 23 between Emerson to Winnipeg. So in a low condition, let's say in a lower condition, we're looking about 38,000 CFS flow at Emerson, and with that we're expecting October 20. So flow could go to 40,000 CFS at Emerson, and we may get a local flow, then we are expecting October 23 time period. So October 22 is the upper side at Emerson. So the most unknown factor here is how much is snow, how fast it's going to melt on the western part of the basin.
So that's for Emerson. And for Winnipeg, expected crest?
So we're looking about the same range, depending on where we're looking at. So October 20 to 23 is still what's expected within the Winnipeg as well. Well, within the Red River Valley, we expect flow and the level will stay within the banks. At some lowland areas, for example, at St. Jean and La Tyler, there is a chance for upper decile, the river could go outside the banks, but we don't expect any communities are affected or any road closure. We don't expect any dike closures at this moment in time. Even though the flow is very high, for this time of the year, we'll be within the banks still. Right, so it's not quite common to see these flows and levels for October, but we still, we are many months away, so we don't know how much precipitation may come. So those six, seven factors that play into spring runoff, including winter precipitation, frost depths, timing of the spring rain, melt rate, all those factors play. So we know only two factors now, which is a base flow, high base flows, and relatively wet soil moisture. So out of the seven factors, we know the two most important factors for now, but still the future is strongly dependent on those five most factors that we don't know.
So no even partial rim dike closures at St. Adolphe's or St. Pierre's, any of those places?
We did a partial closure. Not the ring dike, partial closure of roads on St. Adolphe, mainly because of the operation of floodway.
And there is, we've got reports of like a one property flooded out now from the, with this projection, will there be some private property ring dikes closed, do you think?
No, we don't expect any closure at this point in time.
Not even on individual
no.
Farmhouses?
No.
So
that's a good point. So the map you see on the right here is the amount of precipitation just in the past 7 days. So where you can see, the central Manitoba,
so this is Emerson, so all the central Manitoba, this way the area, the infrastructure affected by precipitation, and the peak of our system within Manitoba is right here, and interlinked is the Fisher River basin. So this is where the maximum amount of precipitation happened. When we move to the west, close to Saskatchewan border, the amount of precipitation is lesser. So this is where the local Colorado system grows. So the map on here is basically percent normal precipitation compared to past many years. So what we see here is green is a kind of near normal. So we're looking about near normal. Light blue is above normal. And in the past, we had a normal, above normal, and extremely above normal. But this year, we weren't able to find because it's way record high. So we added two, three lines here, the pink. We tried to say over 400. We couldn't find a name here. That's why we leave it open. And we have a light bluish between 300 and 400. So when you look at all this area, received over 400% of normal. So this is all the Red River Basin. So significant amount of precipitation. So this is from September 1 all the way up to October 8, and this is without taking into account the precipitation systems that fall in the past few days.
So we are still working that data system. We are doing quality control of that data. By the end of the day or tomorrow, we have these maps based on observed precipitation, including the last system. So basically, as of today, we are adding these two. So it's just the degree of saturation in southern and south central Manitoba. Questions? Fisaha Unduche, Fisaha, UNDUCHE, Fisaha Unduche.